Hello, everybody, and welcome to another Channel 8 sports presentation. Tonight here at the Lewis Brown Athletic Center here on the campus of Rutgers University, it's the Greater Middlesex Conference semifinal round, boys basketball, East Brunswick versus Colonia. Whew, that was a long one, huh, Phil?
You got it out.
Hi, this is Jimmy Hallander being joined by Phil Hill. John will be joining, John Migliaro will be joining us a little bit later. But Phil, we got a game here. East Brunswick is at the Lewis Brown Athletic Center, better known as the RAC. It hasn't been an easy trip for them, has it?
Well, when you consider what we expected from them from the beginning of the year, it's been a wonderful trip for them. They come in here 19-3, and I don't think anyone thought that the Bears would be here at the semifinals today, except for perhaps Bo Henning, and they've just done an incredible job.
Right, and before we talk about tonight's opponent, Colonia, why don't you just bring us up to date on what the road has been like for East Brunswick to get to this point, the semifinals?
Well, if we talk about the GMCs, they've won by identical scores, 55-47. Won over Perth Amboy, a very tough game in East Brunswick. Got down to foul shots down the stretch. East Brunswick made their foul shots and somehow prevailed. And, of course, we know about the double overtime against Donnell, and just a great victory for them. I think a lot of people talk about the exceptional performance by John Corby of Donnell, but overshadowed in that was an exceptional performance by Gray Kolheim. Now, and I'm not talking about the 69 Knicks when Willis Reed walked out, limped back out, but Gray Kolheim went up, twisted his ankle on the tap. They took him in, taped him up, and brought him back out. He had injured his left hamstring in the Perth Amboy game, and I just thought it was a courageous performance from the young fellow to come out and contribute like he did.
Right.
So people tend to say they just escaped the Donnell. They did what they had to do.
Right. Okay, well, let's look at tonight's opponent, Colonia. They're coming in at 21-1. They're the second seed. East Brunswick hasn't played Colonia in quite a number of years, from my recollection, so really an unknown opponent.
An unknown opponent, but a very talented opponent. They are the champs of the white division, and they were here last year, remember, in the semifinals against Piscataway, and played a very tough game against Piscataway before losing. They are the defending Group 3 Central Jersey champs, and they are the white division champs this year as they were last year. So this team can play basketball, and they are basketball players, Jim. You can see these fellows. They look like basketball players. Slender and thin and slender and mercurial. They play good basketball.
Okay. And one more thing about East Brunswick. I know that you talked about the fact that East Brunswick has a greater record this year. They've achieved a lot. Quite honestly, do you think that they should be satisfied just to get to the RAC here tonight? Oh, or do you think that the incentive is still there?
I think the incentive is still there. And they may be in a better position tonight. East Brunswick is used to being the underdog. They relish the role of the underdog. Tonight they are the underdog against Colonia. Against Perth Amboy and against Donnellan, they were favored. I think they were tired. I said that several games back. I talked to Bo Henning last night. He agreed with me that they're tired. He just hasn't had an opportunity to rest them. They had some injuries. Whalen, certainly the player that makes everything go, has had a back problem as well as an ankle injury, and it has hurt the team. Clearly, when Whalen's in that game, to get things moving, they're a different team.
Okay, and of course, we can't forget Matt Van Leeuwen, who's the leading scorer on the team. And collectively, East Brunswick has done a superb job this year. A lot of contributions from a lot of players. Kareem Glover, we're going to see them all tonight. So in just a couple minutes, we're going to bring you the action tonight here from the RAC, the Lewis Brown Athletic Center. East Brunswick versus Colonia, boys basketball, Greater Middlesex Conference semifinals. We'll be ready with the action in just a moment.
Well, good evening and welcome to tonight's semi-final GMC contest between East Brunswick and Colonia. Team's about ready to come out on the court.
This is a first game of a doubleheader, John. St. Peter's and Piscataway will be playing in the second game. And after all is said and done, Phil, these four teams are, I guess, who we expected to see.
You're right.
Piscataway, St. Peter's, East Brunswick, and Colonia.
You're exactly right. The interesting trivia that I found out is three of the four coaches for the four teams live in East Brunswick.
There you go.
That's Kenny Pace, Green for St. Peter's, And Paul Shope for Piscataway. Bo Henning, the only coach that doesn't live in East Brunswick.
Get out of here. I know that. All righty.
We're about ready to go. Kohlheim will jump center for the Bears.
See how his leg is.
Against Morgan, number 30. And Colonia will take control.
And Tyrone Morgan, he's a leaper.
Colonia in the blue, East Brunswick in the white.
Three Chiera quarterback on the football team.
And right away we have a foul against Glover.
I'll tell you, that was a cheesy one to start it off there.
Yeah, you can't, you know.
Bears coming out in the traditional man-to-man, and East Brunswick foul. You're going to see tough man-to-man defense by both teams.
Just whistles like that set the tone for the whole game.
And the first team foul for the Bears.
Colonia moving the ball on the outside. They seem to enjoy a height advantage over East Brunswick. Back door, a little alley-oop. Reverse won't go by Durkak. And rebound, Kohlheim.
And that's got to be the story. Bears have to get on those boards, get those rebounds.
Glover looks across. Kohlheim will take the shot from the key. Short. Glover has it blocked.
Durkak going up, blocking Glover's shot. And Durkak is just a superb athlete, just a fine basketball player. One of the big three there.
This is a senior team, if there ever was one. Only O'Toole, who's, I don't think, in the starting lineup.
Whaling giving it off to Glover. And they're going to call him for traveling.
Okay, little tightness there. But this Colonia team's coming off what Ken Pace said was perhaps the best two quarters that he's ever seen a basketball team that he's coached.
Smith gets it up court quickly. Donnelly with the ball. Back to Smith.
John, we noticed over at Middlesex County College, Phil and I talked about it, the wider court requires a little bit of an adjustment by teams that are not used to playing on that.
Good pass underneath, and Donnelly with the bucket. Pass by Chiera. Whalen being pressured, gets it to Kolakowski. And East Brunswick's got to get it across.
Boy, they had a lot of time there, huh?
Finally do. Van Leeuwen dishes underneath. Glover, we're tied at two.
Good movement of the ball for the Bears.
East Brunswick now pressing.
That was a nice move.
Move inside by Chiera for the basket.
Van Leeuwen bit on that.
4-2, Patriots by two. Glover forces one.
Now they decide to let him play.
Smith giving it off to Durkak. Out to Morgan, long, rebound East Brunswick. Quickly down court to Kohlheim. Yeah. Shot won't go, and Durkak comes up with the rebound.
I'll tell you, you got some tall timber there, and affecting the Bears early on.
Morgan will start things off, Smith rather. Off Durkak.
Just lost it, indeed.
And these are just uncharacteristic errors by both teams. And again, you just blame it on being at this Lewis Brown Athletic Center.
And you watch the Colonia on defense. The difference between them from last year, they were soft on defense, Kenny Pace said. They played a lot of zone because they were soft. Now they play a lot of tough man-to-man defense, and it's made all the difference for them.
We have 5:07 remaining here in the first period. Bears trailing 4-2, and the ball went under the stands.
That's something. There comes another one.
And if you notice, sitting right down to the left of Kolakowski is John Samoji, former coach at St. Joe's and McCorston High, taking in the action. Anyway, East Brunswick goes on offense as they move it around. Van Leeuwen puts one up and hits all net. We're tied at four.
They're going to need his scoring for sure. The leading scorer for the Bears with a 19-point average.
And that's an offense.
Yes, it is. Goodbye, Rich Whalen.
Rich Whalen draws more offensive fouls than anyone on the team and did a fine job there. And that's the value of a Rich Whalen. He does so many things. that don't go in the box score.
Foul on Smith.
And the first team foul.
We remain tied at four. Well into Van Leeuwen. He'll take it and put it up as he moves to his left. Tap in tried by Kohlheim, won't go. Durkak brings it down. Takes the length of the court.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah, he's strung to the hoop.
I'll tell you.
Stolen by Colonia.
Whalen forced that.
Smith moves it back out to the center. Has trouble handling it. Gets it to Durkak, who'll take a three-pointer.
Good. Whoa. Rebound
knocked in, actually, by Donnelly on the rebound attempt.
You're right. He didn't intend on doing that.
And East Brunswick wants a timeout. They're down 8-4.
Well, Henning sees something offensively. On the Colonia offensive side of the floor.
Well, he sees something on his side too. They're a little sloppy right now. Bo wants to slow them down and tell them to pace themselves. They're out of control a little bit.
For in the 2-2-1.
All right, we'll listen in to Bo.
Hey. Okay. Listen to me. One against their 2-2-1 over and away might be the thing to look for, and you got to get down the court as quick as you can. We're shooting too quick in the offense. The break is one thing. The offense, you're going to put us defensively against those big guys too often, okay? We got to lessen the possessions of the game. Make them play some defense. All right, now, they're matching up, right? We're into our walk-up here. And they're matching up. Cream, you're doing the right thing, drifting away. You can go over the top to him early, you do so. Greg, by getting down the court early, you'll keep that deep man with you. He won't be able to come out on Kareem, or if he does, Richie will go right to you. But you gotta get down the court quick. All right, let's go, come on.
Okay, other than obvious strategy, what main point he got across is that they're shooting too quick, some of what we pointed out earlier. They gotta settle down and be more patient with their shots.
Bears will have the ball. They're down by four, 8-4, with 4 minutes showing, first period. Kolakowski out to Whalen. Whalen looks inside, gets it back out to Kolakowski. He's trapped. Look across, bad pass as it's stolen by Donnelly. Ball knocked away, coming up with it is Glover.
Whalen got a hand inside.
And we got a foul call that's going to be on Durkak.
Okay. And Kenny Pace, one of the things he's done is to switch defenses on the Bear. He's moved to the zone there.
Durkak commits the foul. His first.
Well, you heard Henning say that East Brunswick really needs to be a little bit more patient here and get into the half court if they can.
Clock ticking down, 3:25 showing. Bears trailing in this game 8-4. Kohlheim moves it back outside to Whalen. Van Leeuwen being guarded closely by Smith. Tries to roll one in, won't go. Ball's on the ground.
And Tyrone Morgan going up. Well, going up for that ball there. Could have been called for a walk.
Looks like East Brunswick gets possession. Yes. Hartzman make his first appearance.
East Brunswick gets possession.
Van Leeuwen out. Interesting.
Bears, 22, Ben Hartzman is into the lineup.
Bo probably wants to talk to him a little bit, but.
Bears inbound. That's Hartzman with the ball. He's being pressured and throws it away. So Colonia with a 4-point lead. We'll make a substitution. That's O'Toole coming in, number 20.
Who is the only junior, I believe, that plays extensively for Colonia.
O'Toole, a transfer from J.P. Stevens.
That's he with the ball. He gives it off. They look underneath. Morgan has it knocked away, but Donnelly's there to follow up.
He has 6 points.
Whalen being pressured. Gets it across the Cartsman. Glover gets it back out. 6-point lead for Colonia. 2:30 showing, remaining here in the first period. Kolakowski, a little trouble handling it. Kohlheim looks underneath. Glover's there.
And yes.
Now East Brunswick gets some points. Here comes Van Leeuwen again.
That was Kareem Glover.
Colonia's lead cut to 4, 10-6. Durkak drives the lane.
They're going to call offense.
Offensive. That's his second foul. Right.
No basket, Gene Durkak commits the offensive foul, his second.
Whalen will get a rest for the Bears.
For the Patriots, number 5, Trevor Smith is back in the lineup.
And Pace pulls Durkak right away. Certainly didn't want him getting in foul trouble this early.
Kartzman down to Glover. Out to Van Leeuwen for a three-pointer. Short. Ball knocked away by Kolakowski, so it'll go over to Colonia.
Okay, Kolakowski and Kohlheim both going up for the ball. Good hustling.
Okay, East Brunswick with the press here.
Smith brings it up quickly. Looks in the center. No one there. Knocked away.
Oh.
They regain it. Chiara goes out for the three-pointer. Oh. Makes it.
Oh, he's tough.
And for Chiara, that's his 44th three-pointer of the year.
Kohlheim by himself has it knocked away.
Oh, that was a super block by
Donnelly.
Donnelly.
So Colonia very much into their game. They lead 13-6. O'Toole off the back of the rim.
Get the rebound.
Chiara
well.
Once again.
Wow, he's hot.
15-6 with a minute 10. First period. Glover has to throw it away, trying to save it. Goes back to Kolakowski. Kohlheim will take it. Wide right.
And the Bears must maintain their composure right here.
And that wasn't a field goal attempt, was it?
They've got to contain, maintain their composure.
Yeah, they can't let this get out of hand.
Inside 47 seconds now. As the first period winds down, Bears trailing 15-6. And Colonia will set it up, slow it down a bit,
Chiara,
play for that one shot.
Chiara demands a little bit more attention than what he's getting.
30 seconds. O'Toole back out to Smith. O'Toole by himself spins and hits.
Ryan O'Toole.
5 seconds remaining. East Brunswick throws it away.
Okay. We talked about it, and Bo Henning, believe Bo Henning's going to talk about it. The fact of the matter is they have lost the composure, and they got to settle down. A much better team than they're showing.
East Brunswick trailing with 3 seconds left. Shot at the buzzer, and that's it. So after one, it's East Brunswick 6, Colonia 17.
And it'd be interesting to hear what Bo has to say. Bo doesn't get hot too often. He's usually pretty much in control. But right now, his team is out of control.
Fellas, we haven't swung the ball once against the press. We've gone up the same sideline once. We haven't changed sides of the floor even once with it, okay? What's matched up now is guy coming out to steal here. The middle's matched up. The opposite base will be there, okay? The opposite base. Am I wrong? Are you open or you're open, right? So look to swing that. Now, Jimmy, if he gets stuck short in a double team, Kareem's here. Matt is here. Come back so he has an angle, okay? Slow yourselves down, okay? Now, on the defensive end. The defensive end, will you jump in the direction of every pass so that you can get over that screen? I'm only asking you to play 21. Hedge long as you have to and then close out, okay? Come on.
Yeah, you're right, Phil. He is just telling them to do the things that they normally do.
And slow themselves down because they seem to be rushing things, and there's no need to, not even at this juncture.
Well, as we start the second period, Colonia enjoys an 11-point lead, 17-6, and they have the ball. Durkak won't go this time. Kohlheim on the rebound.
It's one of the few misses for them. Here they go again.
Whalen looks down real quick to Kolakowski.
Ooh,
and
mercy.
Can't make it.
A good pass, but just didn't go down.
Got to make those shots. They're not going to get too many opportunities.
Smith to Morgan. He'll use the baseline, and he's fouled by Kolheim.
And I'll tell you, if you, the Patriots have just good movement of the ball. Everybody's touching the ball, and they're getting everybody in the flow of the game. That's making a big difference right now.
So Morgan will go to the line. First foul on Kolheim. Second team foul for East Brunswick.
And Morgan's the 6'5 senior forward, averaging 9.1 points per game.
He'll get one more. And misses both.
But they get the rebound.
Chiara gets the ball, however.
Got a box out.
Chiara for the three-pointer. Yes. Makes it 20-6.
Chris Chiara gets the three.
Kolakowski gets it to Glover. And the pressure by Colonia has been relentless. Van Leeuwen all by himself.
Yes.
There it is, and that's what Bo Henning was talking about.
Take your time.
Swing it over to the opposite side. The man is open, and Van Leeuwen was. 20-9, Chiara drives the baseline, has time. Not this time. And Whalen quickly, right down the court.
Great.
To Kolakowski.
Oh.
Chiara was down at the far end of the court, and Kenny Pace wants a timeout.
Yeah, he's slipping a little bit.
See some things happening. The Bears regain their composure. They're getting back into this game.
And that timeout taken by Colonia.
Well, first run for East Brunswick, two baskets in a row. They do have the ability. East Brunswick has good quickness, and that's about the only thing they're going to do to match up against Colonia.
They have outstanding quickness, and they've been one of the quicker teams in the county all year there. It's just a matter of them settling down and playing their game. Colonia is an outstanding team, as you can see, but when the Bears are playing their game, they can play with anyone.
Yeah, Chiara, by the way, who went out with limping, is the leading scorer. He has 2 3-pointers and 2 regular field goals for 10 points, and Donnelly has 6. For East Brunswick, Van Leeuwen 5, Glover 4, and Kolakowski 2, and that has been it. But East Brunswick definitely needs to do something to get their rebounding is not there either, Phil.
Well, Bo talked to him yesterday. He talked about pursuing the ball. We must pursue the ball. That's what he's going to tell his team before they came out of the locker room. And that's going to the ball, boxing out, doing whatever you have to do because you're up against a much taller team.
Okay, press, John.
Colonia has it. They lead 20-11, 6:45 showing before halftime. Bears down by 9. Smith brings it right into Morgan. Morgan uses the glass a little strong, gets his own rebound, and follows up with the basket.
Morgan gets the follow-up.
22-11.
Again, the rebounding problem.
Whalen with the opening. Uses the glass a little strong. Durkak comes down with it and gives it to O'Toole. Smith gives it to Morgan, back to Durkak. Chiara is out.
The Bears have gone to zone.
Durkak looks underneath for Donnelly, knocked away by Glover.
The Bears have gone to a 1-2-2.
From under their own basket, off the hands of Morgan, Whalen.
Can't believe
and
they
he's
didn't,
fouled by I O'Toole.
I can't believe they didn't call a foul the first time. That was more a foul, an attempt by the Colonia player to just prevent Whalen from getting a shot.
Well, they get the 2 shots for calling it the second time.
Fourth team foul for Colonia, first on O'Toole. Rich Whalen goes to the line.
Rich had 9 points against the Nellon and had 2 big assists down the stretch against Perth Amboy. And I've said it time and time again, he's what makes this East Brunswick Bear team go.
Shooting two. Looking to cut Colonia's lead, which right now is 11 points. Makes the second.
Yeah.
O'Toole quickly brings it up court.
He does a
nice job.
Going
to take it to the hoop, and does.
He does a nice
job. Rebound Kohlheim on the miss.
East Brunswick trying to exploit their speed.
Van Leeuwen drives, and a foul's going to be called, I think, against Donnelly.
And Van Leeuwen just drew that foul. Sort of off balance, no place to go, went up with it, and drew the foul.
Foul was on Smith instead.
So he picks up his second.
And the fifth now for the Patriots, five.
Fifth team foul for Colonia.
Lewin, the shooter, two shots.
Bears down by 10. Looking to chisel away at that as Van Leeuwen brings it down to 9.
And Matt's average down a little bit. He was leading the county, now third in the county with 19.8 points. Came off 17-point performances against both Perth Amboy and Donella.
So he makes both ends of it. Bears trailing by 8, 22-14, 5:30 showing on the clock. We're in the second period, semifinal of the GMCs.
Smith almost lost it.
Smith across to Durkak. Cross court to Chiara, who's back in. Durkak from way out. Rebound knocked away, but Chiara has it.
They get the offensive rebound, don't they?
And they'll start all over again. Chiara looking. Smith, not sure what he's going to do. Gives it to Durkak. He drives, pulls back out. And Smith will take the three-pointer. Rebound, Kohlheim.
I'll tell you, since the Bears have gotten to the zone defense, it seems to have made a difference. Patriots having a tougher time.
Bears trail by 8. Rodgers at number 33 for East Brunswick. Van Leeuwen off the rim. Rodder on the follow-up, has it stuffed by Morgan.
There's Whalen.
Whalen, though, with the three-pointer, won't go. Morgan pulls it down.
And Morgan is a force on the boards.
22-14, Bears trailing by 8.
East Brunswick getting very few points from the perimeter.
Smith's going to take it and hits the three-pointer.
I'll tell you, and that's just a plus for
Smith.
That's just, you're right, it's a plus. You don't expect it.
Kolakowski tries to answer. Won't go, rebound Chiara. Colonia's lead now 11.
Certainly was a reasonable shot.
Durkak has some room and is a little strong. Rebound Kolakowski, 3:30 showing on the clock. We're nearing halftime. Whalen drives, dishes to Rodder. Good play.
I'll tell you.
That was John Rodder.
And I think that's what the Bears have to do. Whalen has to drive and create things. They come to him, he can dish it off.
25-16, Bears down by 9. Smith tries it, won't go this time. Rebound Kohlheim. Looking underneath, Rodder's free. And he's fouled by Donnelly.
Could have been some steps. Rodder got away with it. Great pass again by Whalen. And again, Bears make these baskets. Clearly they're in the game here.
Some wholesale changes for Colonia.
All right, Kohlheim's going to get a rest. Hajika Patosho's in. And Glover returns. Kolakowski leaves.
Rodder the shooter, two shots.
Rodder will shoot two. Six-team foul for Colonia. John Rodder at the line for the Bears. Makes both to decrease Colonia's lead to 7, 25-18.
Bears trying to chip away at that lead.
And the Bears have gone back to the man-to-man. Well, matchup zone.
Clock showing 2:40 before halftime. Colonia looking for an opening.
Whoops.
Look inside.
He walked.
That was Shine, number 33. Cross court, stolen by Van Leeuwen. Has it knocked away. Heinle comes up with it, has the presence of mind to get it to Rotter.
Love it. I'll tell you, good heads up by Matt Van Leeuwen, the complete basketball player.
Knocked away by Whalen, saves it.
I'll tell you,
and he's on the line.
Good
and
try.
You feel the tide turning here.
A little bit.
And it's because of the Bear defense is making things happen, gentlemen.
Bears trailing now only by 5, 25-20.
Clearly creating opportunities for their offense.
Right, exactly.
2 minutes before halftime. Colonia had an 11-point lead just a few minutes ago. It's now down to 5 as they have the ball. O'Toole has it stolen by Van Leeuwen. And he's hacked by O'Toole.
That's a technical.
And that will be called.
That's a technical. It's got to be. He hammered him.
It is, and the Bears will retain possession.
And Kenny Pace saying, why did you call that? But the official right on top of it and just thought it was far too aggressive.
Well, it's not a tech. It's an intentional foul is what it is.
Intentional, which amounts to the same thing.
Exactly. Jeff. But in this sense, though, the player is assessed a team foul.
Team foul. Okay, good point.
Individual foul. So Ryan picks up his second, and that is the 7th team foul for East Brunswick.
And Kenny Pace calls a timeout, so let's listen in to Bo Henney.
All right, now, you have your man matchups, right? And we're 34 in their end of the court. Then we come back, and their guards are spitting it up, right? So keep good pressure on them. But we come back here, let's play an intelligent 51 without giving them a second shot, okay? Keep hustling them. We got to have somebody on the ball each time. The forwards will take it till the guards can get there. Then you drop off. If you get a screen in this, you got to understand why you're being screened. There's probably somebody coming off a back screen. So fight through it. And if you see a guy screening, you may have to hedge from the backside, okay? Yeah. Even though you're in that zone. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes. Okay. When we inbound, right? We have on intentional on the baseline.
I think it's on the baseline, so we'll go numbered. We'll go with the numbered play. If it's all I want out of the cans is to kill a little time. But I'll tell you what, where we are right now, let's go right into Utah. Let's run a Utah at him one time. Listen to me. If you don't have something out of Utah, though, let's go right into Kansas, okay? All right, come on.
Slow it up. Slow it up, too.
I'll tell you, all I know, we've been to 3 different states. and speaking strategy here. But, again, the Bears are back into the flow of the game, playing great defense. Defense is what has turned it around for them. Is that the line? And they got to continue it.
Van Leeuwen showing his coolness. I guess if I was hacked like that, I probably want to go after the player.
Ooh.
Not meant to be.
And he's the top free throw shooter for the Bears here, about 70%.
Does make the second. And he'll go out to East Brunswick on the side.
Right.
I'll tell you.
Henning wants to use a little bit of time.
And now East Brunswick gets possession.
I'll tell you, the Bears are in great position right now.
1:40 showing on the clock.
Better than they were a couple of minutes ago, that's for sure.
They're trailing by 4, 25-21. Colonia has 17 fouls already. So East Brunswick could be the beneficiaries of some bonus situations if fouled.
They spread them out here.
Kohlheim looks, being pressured, looks underneath to
great
Van Leeuwen.
Pass.
That was a great pass.
Bears down by 2.
Wow, they've really, their lead has shrunk real quick.
1:15 showing on the clock. Chiara looks inside. Morgan is there, has it knocked away.
I think he lost it.
Ooh. They're going to say it's East Brunswick player knocked it away.
You see the Bears clapping their hands. You can see the confidence flowing.
Okay, got to watch the inside pass here.
Morgan, short, rebound Kohlheim. Minute 8.
They can tie it.
Incredible.
Rotter. Cross court to Kohlheim. He drives, looks inside, has it stolen by O'Toole. 52 seconds remaining. Chiara, short.
But they get the rebound.
Morgan's right there, however, follows up for the bucket.
East Brunswick has to get more rebounds.
40 seconds showing on the clock. Bears down by 4, 27-23. Looks like they're playing for the 1.
Patriots still in man-to-man.
22 seconds as Whalen Tries to knock off some time.
Wow.
Gets it to Van Leeuwen, but after Chiara had his hand on it.
Colonia really in a denial defense.
Playing tough defense right now.
Ryder going out. Gave East Brunswick a couple of good minutes, 6 points.
East Brunswick now with 15 seconds. Clock going down. Kohlheim inside 10, and he's fouled by Donnelly.
And he'll shoot through.
And as we said, they're in the bonus situation.
So you have four players from Colonia with two fouls. Donnelly, Smith, O'Toole, and Durkak.
Kohlheim will go to the line.
And speaking of Kohlheim out of the line, what a job he did against Donnell, and I believe 8 out of 10 down
eight
the stretch.
Out of 10, you betcha.
And he could use a couple of them right here.
I don't know if you're realizing that Donnell in game, every point in both overtimes came on the foul line.
In the last 11 minutes, they did not score a field goal.
Greg will get another.
I'm telling you, he is in a zone on the foul line. He is really a 60% shooter before that.
Bears down by three. Kohlheim can make it two, and he does.
But nothing but net both
25,
times.
25-27, 9 seconds remaining.
And the key is to prevent Colonia from getting a good shot off here.
3 seconds.
And they won't.
That'll do it.
I'll tell you.
Nice job.
So at halftime, East Brunswick cuts down the Colonia 11-point lead to go in trailing 27-25.
I got to tell you, you know, after that 17-6 first quarter, East Brunswick has to be tickled pink to be down by 2 points.
Well, Jim, it's like we said from the get-go, all they had to do was settle down and play their game. If you're Ken Pace and the Patriots, you got to be stung a little bit. They thought they had control of the game and actually were about to run away with it. And the Bears, through their defense, causing turnovers, being aggressive, got themselves back in the game, and momentum is clearly with the Bears.
So it's halftime here at Rutgers Athletic Center. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back with the start of the third period in just a moment. Well, we welcome you back to tonight's semifinal game, East Brunswick-Colonia, the Bears trailing 27-25. The story here in the first half has been East Brunswick's ability to rally back and overcome an 11-point deficit. And Jimmy, I know you have some scoring highlights.
Well, Van Leeuwen was part of that effort. He comes in first half scoring 10 points. The thing about East Brunswick is they were 8 for 10 from the line, kind of picking up from where they at the Donnelly game, right? Kohlheim had two for two from the line, so he has 2 points. Kolakowski, two. Kareem Glover, he had four. Whalen, 1 for 2 from the line. And John Rotter, a surprising 6 points for East Brunswick scoring. So there you have it. Although East Brunswick has not been as fortunate on we don't have offensive rebounding statistics, and the defensive boards, but that's one area where they really want to improve.
Well, they're in the game. They had an 18-10 run, and that's made the difference here. When they easily could have been out of the game when it was 17-6. So you got to give the Bears a lot of credit. They got to continue playing like this because right at the half, momentum clearly was with them.
The winner of this game tonight will take on the winner of the second game of the doubleheader. That is St. Peter's and Piscataway in the finals here Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock. Anyway, Bears will start off the third period with the ball, and this is Whalen. Whalen has the alley and the lane. A little short on the bucket, however.
He's forced to alter his shot.
And quickly, Smith brings it down. He'll take the shot. Short. Yeah, rebound, Glover.
So we mentioned that four Colonia players have two fouls, so they're going to have to watch it.
And we talked about shot selection. That wasn't a bad one, but Colonia hasn't been hitting on their shots as of late.
Kohlheim underneath. Gets it back out. Glover's by himself. Decides to bring it out.
East Brunswick really hesitant to take that outside shot.
Kohlheim, he gets the foul. He draws the foul.
On Donnelly, that's his third. I believe it's on Donnelly.
We'll see. First team foul for Colonia.
Colonia foul is charged to Tyrone Morgan.
It's Morgan, number 30.
It's Morgan.
Team foul in this half.
And Greg will have one more.
Greg Kohlheim has one more shot coming.
and makes it and puts the Bears within one, 27-26.
Okay. Good defense.
Very quiet start here to the third quarter after an exciting first half.
Crowd settling in.
This is Smith with the ball.
Tough matchup with Durkak, Glover having to cover Durkak.
Morgan spins and fires. 29-26, Colonia by three.
Tyrone Morgan with a fine move there, one-on-one.
Van Leeuwen. Being pressured.
Double teaming.
They look down low, no one there. Glover gets it out, but it's right to Chiara, two-on-one.
Good block.
I'll tell you.
Oh!
And they're going to call a foul on Van Leeuwen.
And Chiara held the ball too long. Clearly had somebody out on the wing. I believe Durkak just didn't get it off to him.
First team foul for East Brunswick. And first foul for Van Leeuwen.
The Bears first in this half.
So Chiara will go to the line, shoot two.
Chiara at the line for two.
And Chiara, Chris Chiara, 6'2 senior guard. Averaging 15 points per game.
Puts Colonia on top, 31-26, 5-point lead. Whalen has a lane, drives, tries to get it off to Kohlheim, who gets it back out to Van Leeuwen. Good heads-up play by Kohlheim.
Is that a three?
That's a three.
Okay.
Van Leeuwen.
31-29.
I'm telling you, if he can get hot.
Bears down by two as O'Toole has it for Colonia. Durkak jams it. And that brings the crowd to its feet. Glover trying to follow up, and he's fouled by Donnelly.
And Durkak did bring the crowd to his feet. He's known to do two or three dunks per game. So.
That Colonia foul charged to Jason Donnelly.
Glover will go to the line, third foul on Donnelly, number 34.
And if you can get Donnelly out, he's one of the big rebounders. Matter of fact, second on the team in rebounds, 7.1.
Glover. This is the first.
Okay, follow through.
Bears trailing by four, 33-29. We're in the third period, 6 minutes showing.
Bears hanging close here.
Okay, pressure by the Bears.
Glover makes it 33-30 as O'Toole gets it across to Donnelly. To Morgan, looks across. Chiara by himself, three-point land. Not this time. And it'll go to East Brunswick.
That was way out.
Okay, it appears the Patriots aren't doing things within the flow of the game there. I mean,
right.
Chiara's looking to get that three-pointer. He's all day he's been moved. When he's close to the line, he'll move back over it in order to take the three-point shot. Sometimes you concentrate too much on that. It takes you out of your game.
Bears down by three. Kolakowski. And a little mix-up on the ball. Finally, Donnelly puts his hands on it.
What was Kolakowski thinking?
Colonia on top, 33-30. They have the ball. 5:15 remaining, third period. Durkak gets it back out. O'Toole sees a room, drops the shoulder,
ooh,
and they're going to call a foul on Whalen.
Jeez. Well, you called it. O'Toole did drive in there, did drop the shoulder.
So it's
leaned
though.
In, but official standing there, and O'Toole able to get the call.
Not a shooting foul.
Not a shooting foul.
Right.
Morgan has it blocked.
Oh, he
comes
gets
up with
back.
His own rebound and uses the glass.
Again, that's the offensive boards are killing East Brunswick.
Patriots by five, 35-30. Whalen gives it to Kolakowski.
Bears have gone back. Colonia stays in the man-to-man, rather.
Van Leeuwen, three-pointer. Short. Kohlheim
oh, yes.
on the follow-up. 35-32. Bears down by three.
He's on the line.
And he's on the line. Durkak.
And I tell you, Kareem Glover just riding him. Forced him out of bounds without forcing him out of bounds. the Bears get control of the ball.
They're down by three, 4:20. Van Loewen to Glover. They look inside to Kolheim.
Nice pass.
Kolakowski standing there, has it blocked by Morgan, and they're going to call a foul.
They're going to call it on O'Toole.
I didn't even see him there, but yep. That's who the foul's on.
And he picks up his third. So Colonia, two players with three fouls. We got to watch this.
Got it, Donnelly and O'Toole.
His third and the third team foul.
Smith comes back in for Colonia.
For the Patriots.
And Chiaro will take a rest.
For Kolakowski.
Could put East Brunswick within one.
And Bo Henning seeing Kolakowski's praise, young man willing to play out of position in order to help the team. A natural guard, but must play forward in order to help the team.
And he does just that, puts East Brunswick within one, 35-34.
I'll tell you what, East Brunswick is fortunate to be going to the foul line as often as they have.
Stolen by Kolakowski. Gives it to Kolheim coming down the lane.
Oh, mercy, yes.
They take the lead.
And the Bears are on top for the first time tonight, 36-35.
Bears looking awfully fluid.
East Brunswick gets the lead at 36-35.
Morgan has trouble with it and loses. Oh, they're saying it's off East Brunswick, off Kolheim.
And clearly, once again, it's the defense that is turning things up for the Bears. When they play that all-out style and hassle the Patriots, they create turnovers and turns into points.
3:45 left in this quarter. Bears on top by one, 36-35. O'Toole, three-pointer. Yes.
Oh, big one.
Colonia back on top by two. Glover to Kolakowski. Drives, gives it off to Glover. Glover takes the shot, too strong. Kolheim's there, however. Glover back.
Yes.
Makes the play.
Nice.
I'll tell you, great movement of the ball.
East Brunswick with a lot more confidence now.
Tied at 38. 3 minutes remaining, third period. O'Toole to Chiara. Back out. Colonia slowing it down considerably here.
Well, they're trying to get the right match.
Morgan will take it and makes it.
Tyrone
Morgan with 10 points.
So Colonia back up on top, 40-38, 2:30 remaining. Whalen drives, loses control of it. Durkak with the rebound, somehow gets it to Morgan. O'Toole from way out.
Wow.
Donnelly.
Oh.
Tries to jam it, won't go. Morgan has it stripped.
Somehow East Brunswick comes out with that.
And Van Leeuwen has it.
No, but they don't have the matchup, though.
Three. Van Leeuwen will take the three. Yes.
Yes. Mercy.
Bears by one, 41-40.
There's that crowd.
And Whalen knocks Durkak from behind.
And I'll tell you, this reckless abandon, usually a term applied for football, but the Bears are going all out defensively.
Right,
and that
chances.
Is what's doing it.
Well, I'll tell you, what's fortunate for them is that they don't have a lot of team fouls. That's the third. And really, nobody's in foul trouble. Whalen has just picked up a second. Nobody else has one foul. More than one foul, I should say.
Karsman and Aji Batosho check in for the Bears.
And Bo Henning doing a masterful job using his bench.
Morgan.
Apparently that was a two-pointer by Van Leeuwen, was it not?
No, O'Toole. Somehow Morgan comes up with it and the basket. We're going back and forth here, 42-41. Now Colonia. Kartzman in the corner to Van Leeuwen. Yes, he's hot.
Three-pointer.
That's his fourth three-pointer.
That's the streak shooting that you want to see from him.
44-42 with a minute 20. Third period action. Bears by two.
I tell you, Van Loon with 66 three-pointers.
Morgan, three-pointer, short. Rebound off Katzman.
Well, I'll tell you what. You want to let Morgan take the three-pointer, even though he's the leading scorer right now. He's got, I believe, 12 points. Colonia knows it's in a game, John.
Right now, they're quite willing to shoot from the outside. Durkak, not this time.
That was blocked. Second offensive rebound. And
Fine, saves it for him. O'Toole back over to Morgan. Little spin, nowhere to go. O'Toole, in and out. Yeah, rebound, Aji. Foul against Stein.
And they're starting to pick up the team fouls once more. That's the fourth team foul.
We have 40 seconds remaining here in the third period. Bears are on top, 44-42. They trailed at one time by 11 points in this game.
Okay, and Rotter in for...
They'll play for the one. Van Leeuwen has the ball.
Kolakowski.
Rotter with the ball.
Pressure.
25 seconds.
Oh!
Gets it across. Glover's there.
Intelligently slows it up.
15 seconds. Rotter back out to Aji. Aji drives. Gives it to Glover. 6 seconds.
They got to shoot it.
2 seconds. And a wasted opportunity. Rotter at the buzzer.
Oh, almost went in.
I'll tell you.
So at the end of three, the Bears are on top, 44-42.
Just a exciting, wonderful third quarter for the Bears.
It really was. Put up another 19 spot for the East Brunswick Bears.
Let's listen in to Bo.
Nice job, Timmy. Timmy, pull that board down. Right here, right? Coach said you guys weren't sure what. Hey, coach said you weren't sure what you're gonna do against 1-2-1-1. You know we're talking sliders, right?
Yeah.
Everybody stays in their lane. Matt stays in the two. Cream stays in the three. The four man's got to stay with the one man. Go opposite, stay with them, right?
Yeah.
You got to make the decision. Do I slide middle when the ball is away from me, or do I go over and away? Okay. Now, if they half court trap you like they did. If we don't, if we're in open and we get caught, make sure one of the opposite guys fill the high post. Right. Fill the high post. Let's go. Same day. 34 back to 20, 51. 51.
All right, here we go. The final 8 minutes. Bears holding on to a 2-point lead, 44-42. Colonia will take possession. They look inside.
Really trying to deny the big men the ball inside.
Donnelly misses. Rebound, Morgan. And they have not been able to box him out.
That's the trouble. That's
the Morgan's been the man that's keeping the Patriots in the game.
Tied at 44, Kartzman.
There's the double team.
Gets it back out to Rotter. Rotter down to Glover. He's got the open shot and the basket.
Yes. Glover with 9 points.
Right.
Bears by two, 46-44. Knocked away by Van Leeuwen.
He will take it himself.
Pulls up, takes the jumper, yes. Bears by four, 48-44.
Points for Matt Van Leeuwen.
Yep.
O'Toole gets it to Chiera. Morgan along the baseline. Has it blocked by Kohlheim. They're going to call him on the foul.
I'll tell you, it looked like a good block. But again, Morgan with a nice move on the baseline, going up and drawing the foul.
Charge to number 24, Greg Kohlheim, his second, the fourth team foul.
Second foul on Kohlheim.
And you take a good look at Tyrone Morgan, a 6'5 senior forward, averaging 14.8 points per game. And he's been the main man for the Patriots tonight.
Well, the problem with the clock, it's showing 24-20, and that's even a bit much for a college half.
And as they look at the clock, gentlemen, here, again, you got to be terribly impressed with what the Bears have done from the second period on to take control of this game.
Right, Phil, and I don't think you can underestimate the value of the the experience that these underclassmen are getting by playing this way in front of this crowd.
Well, I talked about it before. Bo Henning doing a masterful job using his bench, clearly giving his starters a breather, but also getting experience for the underclassmen. And just a fine all-around job.
Well, the referee is talking to both coaches to see if they could come up with an equitable, an agreeable time on the clock, and they've put 6 minutes and 50 seconds back on.
Got to think that this break here benefits East Brunswick a little bit, this brief rest.
If you've just joined us, you're missing a whale of a game, or you have missed it up to this point. The Bears were down at one point by 11 points. They are now in the lead 48-44 as Morgan goes to the line and cuts the lead now to three that East Brunswick enjoys.
Morgan at his average with 15 points right there.
We're in the final period of this game. Semifinals, GMC. The winner of this game will take on the winner of the Piscataway-St. Peter's game. And that will be played this Saturday here at the RAC.
Van Leeuwen taking a brief rest.
And you can look for both teams to take care of the ball from now on. Going to be sure about the shots. How they move that ball around.
Whalen, with the ball. Bears with a two-point lead has it stripped by Smith.
Okay.
Chiara.
Way out.
Three-pointer.
Way out.
Off the rim. Rebound Glover. Looking for some help. Gets it from Kohlheim. Whalen's by himself. Had some thoughts. Drives. Pulls up. Yes. 50-46.
Whoa, almost.
Big basket by Whalen. 4 points.
.550 remaining in the game. Bears by four. Colonia content to move it around the outside.
And the Bears in that matchup zone.
Look underneath. Foul is going to be called as DeKirk.
And I tell you, they've been doing a job on Durkak. Durkak came out and hit two quick baskets early on. He is the leading scorer for these Patriots here. 18 points per game, but he only has 4 points, Jim. So they've been doing the job on Durkak.
He's at the line now. Missing. Oh, I thought he missed that one.
Friendly bounce.
One shot.
Oops, they give the point to East Brunswick. Never mind.
50-47, 50-48 now. Bears by two.
Shooter's touch.
5:35 on the clock. They look down for Kohlheim. He's there, and he's fouled.
By Morgan.
And I think they're going to call it on O'Toole.
If it is, it's his fourth.
It is on O'Toole. 15 foul for Colonia.
Fourth now on O'Toole. Five team foul.
Running in a little bit of a foul problem.
Kohlheim at the line, shooting two.
Kohlheim can increase East Brunswick's lead. Makes the first.
Some people just like the pressure situations, Jim. You wonder why his foul shooting can go up so greatly. Well,
rebound, O'Toole. Bears by three, 51-48.
They're going to try to get it inside.
Smith looking. Pulls back out. Morgan will drop out and take the three-pointer. And we're going to have a foul underneath Kolakowski.
Didn't have to foul him either. East Brunswick was going to get that board.
Kolakowski trying to get position there. Durkak got underneath him. Kolakowski sort of muscled him down.
So that's a six-team foul for East Brunswick. Next one is going to be a one-on-one. Fortunately, Kolakowski, that's his first foul. East Brunswick individually is not in foul trouble, but now they have to watch for the one-on-one situations.
Colonia inbounds. Morgan spins and lays it right in.
He's having a whale of a game, isn't he?
Super game. Tyrone Morgan, a super game. And if Tyrone Morgan isn't hot, the Patriots are in trouble.
18 points.
Bears by one. Clock shows inside 5 minutes left in the game. Kolakowski being pressured. Steps through it. Has it knocked away by DeKirk. saved back to Kolakowski.
There's Kohlheim right there. He should have had his arms waving.
He finally gets it. Goes back across. Ooh. Stolen by Chiara.
Those cross-court passes.
Knocked away by...
Wow, who wants it?
It's hard to keep up with this one. Kohlheim, look at him hustle.
He really isn't giving an effort.
East Brunswick needs to settle in now on defense. They have a one-point lead. Clock moving. Morgan.
He's hitting in clutch situations,
well, he
too.
He did it before. When they played Kennedy, they won 68-64. It was Morgan who had 19 points and 12 rebounds, which made the big difference for him, man. He's coming up big here.
Yeah, he is.
And with that basket, Colonia takes the lead, 52-51. And let's listen in to Bo.
You a sub? All right, hey, listen to me. You got to glance over here. When we're changing defenses, it seems like I'm confusing you more than I am them. Mr. Niskins will be holding up either a 51 or a 21, okay? All right, now you're starting to get some double teams. The opposite man fill a high post, or think about that long skip. The long skip has been there, right? All right? We got two timeouts left now. We don't want to burn them unless we need to, okay? All right. After that last bucket, they were trying to go to that 2-2-1 press again. So you got to get into your walk-up spot. Take your time in the backcourt with it, right? What's the matter? Whoa, come here. What's the matter?
No one's covering, Mike. You have to walk back real quick so I can kick it ahead before the trap.
Well, some good instruction by Bo Henning. Staying calm as usual. We're in a dogfight here. Bears down by one, 52-51. Whalen to Kolakowski. Each possession now is going to be very important. 4 minutes showing on the clock. Whalen gets it back out to Glover. Kohlheim thinks about it, gives it to Glover, back out. Van Leeuwen will take it. Yes!
Three. Is it not?
Yes, it is, a three-pointer.
I'll tell you, his fifth.
But fortunately for the Bears, he's starting to warm up now.
Five.
Bears back on top, 54-52. And a foul by Kolakowski. And that'll be East Brunswick's seventh team foul.
The East Brunswick foul charged to 32, Kolakowski. Jim Kolakowski gets his
So they'll go to the 1-1 situation.
And I'll tell you, Van Leeuwen always already leading the county. Well, second in the county in three-pointers. Padding it here with five big three-pointers.
And he has 23 points to lead the scoring for the Bears.
And Durkat goes to the line, see if he can sink.
Looking to tie this game up. Puts Colonia back in within a point.
Just his fifth point of the game.
In and out. And it goes over to East Brunswick. So the Bears holding on to a one-point lead. 3:30 showing on the clock. Semifinals from the Rutgers Athletic Center.
Whoa.
Whalen skips through somehow. Gives it to Glover. Whalen's free, three-pointer. Off the rim, but Kohlheim's right there.
Oh!
In and out.
I'll tell you, Kohlheim put up a nice arch, made an adjustment, and the ball ringed around and came out.
Durkak, and he's fouled by Whalen.
Okay, no harm. No harm there, a little extra. People just off balance there. But let me correct that. Durkak with 7 points, still 11 below his average.
Well, East Brunswick chiming in with the fouls now in this quarter.
Durkak back at the line. And East Brunswick has 17 fouls, so Colonia, the beneficiaries of the bonus situation. And we're tied at 54.
This, I believe, was a two-shot foul, John.
Well, regardless, they're on top. That is the Patriots, 55-54.
Yes.
Kohlheim, wide open, good pass from Glover. And we're going back and forth.
We'll need to relax just a moment.
Bears by one, 56-55. 2:45 showing on the clock as Chiara takes the three-pointer.
Yeah, he's off now.
And Glover.
He's definitely off. He's
has Kohlheim again.
Down court, just a little too far, Van Leeuwen.
A little too much. Van Leeuwen hits his chest, says, my fault. Kohlheim says, no problem.
And isn't Greg Kohlheim giving everything he's got?
I tell you, the racehorse.
Smith gets it over to Morgan. They look across and underneath for Chiara, throws it away.
Morgan, a little too tough. And now we're getting down to critical possession time.
I talked about taking care of the ball and during this period of time, and both teams a little bit loose with it, trying to get that quick basket.
Bears by one, 56-55. Clock showing 2:23. Glover gives it to Van Leeuwen. He spins, turns, and hits.
That's the chance you take when you do the press. And East Brunswick has been very good at exploiting that.
Bears by three. 2 minutes left in this game. Durkak from way out, rebound Van Leeuwen.
Not an intelligent shot at this juncture.
You want to slow it down
a
little bit.
East Brunswick really can afford to take its time.
Van Leeuwen will give it to Glover. Drives in to Kolakowski. And East Brunswick with the advantage of the clock and the points on the board. Kolakowski.
Oh.
Won't go, rebound, Donnelly. And Kohlheim quickly ties him up.
It's a jump ball, and who has the possession? East Brunswick.
I'll tell you.
Wow, what a great
heads
time
up play
to
by
have
Kohlheim.
Possession.
1:35 showing.
And you take a look at Greg Kohlheim, he's just exhausted. He is totally exhausted because he's giving it all out there, as is everyone else for the Bears.
Boy, I'll tell you what, East Brunswick was very fortunate that time.
Clock moving down, 1:30 remaining. Bears by three, 58-55. Kohlheim, who's played a super second half here, will take it up, has it blocked by Morgan.
Don't know why they shot it.
1:15. Smith over to Durkak. Smith has put a few up, and Kenny Pace wants a timeout.
I tell you.
Colonia.
Boy, I tell you. I'm not sure why Greg Kohlheim went up with that. It was not a good shot.
He went up because he was open, but he's a little tired, as I pointed out. And Tyrone Morgan, who's been a force defensively all along, blocked it. Bo Henning saying something to Greg right now, but pats him on the butt. No problem.
All right, we'll listen in to Bo.
Wait, there's a minute to go in the game. You ain't coming out. No. He's telling me he's tired. No, they won't allow me to take you out. I'm sorry. Okay, we need you. All right, here we go. Defensively, I don't want to back off the pressure because the pressure's on them, right? It's on them. As long as we play it tough without fouling, all right? Now, know the situation. We're going to fall back now into our 51D, right? We can't give up a second shot. Those three guys along the baseline, you got to be real active. They're not calling over the back, so you really got to create space and go get the ball. All right, let's go.
Well, apparently, Greg Kohlheim was asking to come out.
Well, I told you he was exhausted. He's totally exhausted because he's given it all. And mentioned about coming out for a breather, and Bo Henning said, no way you're coming out. We've heard some classics before, usually from Reggie Carney, but this one's great.
All right, Colonia with the ball, a minute left. They trail by three, 58-55. You heard Bo Henning saying, playing good heads-up defense. Clock down to 50.
And are they working for a three-point shot?
It's got to be. 44 seconds. Chiara will take it. No good. Rebound. Durkak loses it. Kohlheim has it.
And his ankle went down. He hurt his ankle.
And a timeout. Durkak is down.
He's down.
Obvious pain.
Clock stopped with 35 seconds.
A little bit of a break for Colonia in that East Brunswick had a three-on-one advantage down this end of the court.
I'll tell you, but you take a look at the young man down there, Gene Durkak, a three-year starter for him, a 6'4 senior, the leading scorer for the Patriots, averaging 18 points per game and 7.5 rebounds per game. And he's been their Mr. Everything. You see Kenny Pace out there taking a look at him right now. And He's concerned. They, you know, this is a game, and they'd like to win this game, but they have more games. They have the states to look forward to as well.
So Henning is drawing up his offensive plan here. I think he knows. I think what he's trying to do is he's going to try to get the ball in Van Leeuwen's hands because Colonia is now in a position where they have to foul, and you want your best foul shooter on the line, and that is Matt Van Leeuwen.
You want your best foul shooter. You want your best ball handler. They may, it could go into Whalen as well. They want somebody who's going to control the ball.
They're still attending to Durkak on the floor. Apparently, he twisted his ankle.
And another beneficiary of this is Greg Kohlheim, who was exhausted before.
He gets a chance to rest.
Well, and it was Kohlheim who came up with the ball at the far end of the court.
And we certainly hope Durkak is all right there. They continue to take a look at him. But 35.2 seconds left in this game. And
John Nason.
If East Brunswick just plays an intelligent game from here on in, there's no reason why they can't come on out top.
Just a tremendous effort. We talked about, Bo Henning talked about giving it your all and leaving it all out on the court. And
so now you have some emergency
medical
attendance. Yeah.
Right. Some of the emergency medical personnel on the court.
Not quite sure whether he came down on somebody's ankle and that caused him to have it twisted or whether just something gave out on his own. But he is certainly in a lot of pain, and you don't think he can continue, obviously. Being helped up now, John. It's not putting any weight on it.
They'll help him to the sideline and to the bench where they can better look at him.
That looks like an injury that could keep him out for a while.
Keep him out for a little while.
Well,
as I said, they
maybe seeing him in his last game for the Patriots.
Well, let's hope not, because he's had a great career.
Really?
Do we
know where he's going to college? Because he's certainly a
number
college
of schools,
player.
St. Peter's and a few others looking at him. So,
okay.
Again, he's a ball player, has a good future ahead of him.
Well, here's the situation. We have 35 seconds remaining in this game. East Brunswick has the ball. They also have a three-point lead, 58-55.
And two timeouts left.
That's important to note.
Kolakowski gets Glover. Big move there to Kohlheim.
Good move to get it out.
To Van Whalen. To Whalen, to Van Leeuwen.
Now they got a foul.
25 seconds.
Oh, I'm surprised.
And they're going to foul Kolakowski.
They're trying to wait to foul who they wanted. They didn't want to foul Kohlheim because he's been hitting them. They didn't want to foul Van Leeuwen, and they finally got Kolakowski.
Quite frankly, they don't want to foul Whalen because he's a good foul shooter as well.
They had a foul to give up.
So that's nobody shooting anyway.
So Donnelly picks up his fourth, not that it means too much at this point. But
24 seconds now remain.
Whoa!
Almost stolen by Chiara. Whalen gets it off, and he's fouled by Smith.
Third foul. And that should be a one-on-one for Richie Whalen.
And he will go to the line, Jim. You're right.
His third.
And these are big shots. This is the big one right here. This will make the margin four.
Whalen at the line. Misses. Rebound Morgan. 17 seconds. O'Toole brings it up quickly. 15.
They have to go for the three.
13. Timeout. I believe that's the last timeout for Colonia.
I'll tell you now.
Patriots with a little bit of life.
Kenny Pace strategizing right now.
Remember the last game against Dinellen there, the Dinellen player, Corby, puts up a three-pointer with 3 seconds left to tie the game.
And conceivably one will be put up here. Bo Henning does not want him to foul, though.
I would say Chris Chiara is probably the one that's going to take the shot. He's been the most consistent three-point. He has two of the five for the Patriots. So we're going to have to watch him. They're going to try to work the play.
Well, you couldn't ask for a better game. Colonia came in with a 21-1 record, second seed in the conference. East Brunswick 19-3, third seed in the conference. And there's Piscataway and St. Peter's yet to come. But this game has been really unbelievable. East Brunswick down by 11 points in the first half, chipped away to within two at halftime, came back, took the lead in the third period, held on to that lead as it seesawed, finally holding on to a three-point lead here for the last about minute and a half. Colonia will have the ball. They'll have 12 seconds remaining. They need 3 points to tie. Both teams with 17 fouls.
Glover on Chiara.
Smith to Morgan. 9 seconds. He'll take the three-pointer. That this tap in won't go. Rebound. Kohlheim. Oh my God. Greg Kohlheim with 4 seconds.
Poetic justice.
And who took that shot? Tyrone Morgan.
Tyrone Morgan. And let's see, Tyrone Morgan.
Kohlheim with big foul shots here.
That's very strange. Tyrone Morgan has only made 2 three-pointers this year. Dirkak's out. He had the most with 8, and O'Toole is the next best shooter with 7.
I thought Chiara would be the one taking it.
Kohlheim makes the big one that is needed.
That is the one that'll do it for the Bears.
Yes. And they call timeout.
4 seconds. And East Brunswick's already celebrating.
And I tell you, it appears the Bears are going to the big party here, gentlemen. And just an unbelievable story. Of course, we got 4.2 seconds left.
Well, the thing I want to point out is that the girls are going to be in the finals as well. What a tremendous year for the Bears. Totally unexpected in my mind. I mean, you really couldn't think that this team, as well as the girls' team, would be able to make it to the finals. And here they are.
No doubt about it. And, Rob, you got a few of the East Brunswick faithful up, but seems to me they should be going crazy about now. But they're going to wait till all the time is ticked off.
Well,
I'll tell you this
happy.
Here. Colonia against New Brunswick scored an 8-point play.
An eight-point play
against New Brunswick, which made the big difference. Of course, we don't expect to see any 8-point plays or any 4-point plays or 5-point plays here. But they did do that.
They are in desperate shape now. Colonia is. Their heads are bowed. I think this is a real tough situation for them.
Well, the fat lady is clearing her throat, getting ready with 4 seconds remaining. And Kohlheim at the line. And what a game this young man has had, particularly this second half. Really is moot. 3 seconds. Smith, I don't know what he's waiting for.
Game.
That's it, East Brunswick.
I'll tell you.
Beats second seeded Colonia 59-55.
And it's an upset in every sense of the word.
And I'll tell you what, this is the biggest victory for East Brunswick in a number of years. Number of years. Probably the biggest victory since this the county tournament victory back in 1988-89. Wouldn't you say?
Frank Mappenberger's team. But this is just unbelievable, I'll tell you. Again, Bo Henning spoke to him last night, very calm, was eager to get here and but you got to believe, Jim, that to be in the finals this year is just incredible.
It's a shock for Bo Henning. I'm going to tell you that. I know he doesn't believe that his team would have made it here, but they have. And now just to get into the finals, regardless who they play, whether it be Piscataway or St. Peter's, they're going to be tickled pink, and they're going to benefit by the experience. And, wow, what can you say?
The Cinderella story continues as East Brunswick improves their record to 20-3. And what a great team effort. I mean, when things look bleak, and boy, we thought they were bleak there in the first half, East Brunswick hung tough, following the advice of Bo Henning, came back, chipped away to take the lead eventually in the third period, and eventually then go on to win this game. And Jimmy, I know you have some thoughts.
Well, John, just one other thing. I know you had mentioned that there was an 11-point lead. Actually, the lead got up to 13 points at one point for Colonia, and then East Brunswick would just not give up. I thought they were in trouble because they couldn't get the boards, but they really hung in there. And I like go back to that minute and a half left when Greg Kohlheim wanted to come out, and the team
really
rallied around themselves, and I think they found themselves at that point, probably elevated their maturity and their the team spirit just a little bit more. And I think it was a nice moment for the Bears.
And one of the great lines I've ever heard, Bo Henning looks at Greg Kohlheim and says, the team won't let me take you out.
And someone in the group says, you'd never want to come out in football. Why do you want to come out now?
It was classic. But
let me say this here about Bo Henning. This is his shiny moment for him, regardless of what happens. Bo Henning, I get a chance to speak to the opposing coaches, as you know, and to a man, each of them talk about Bo Henning being one of the top coaches in all this area here, and he certainly is that. He's a gentleman, but also excellent coach. On the other hand, for Kenny Pace there, what can you say? The second year in a row that he's come to the semifinals to lose it. But Kenny Pace has had his time. 1990, when he was coaching with JFK, he won it all here. So he knows the thrill of victory, but also the agony of defeat.
Well, again, East Brunswick goes into the finals, which will be will be played here Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock. We're yet to know who they're going to play, either Piscataway or St. Peter's. Regardless, they've gotten this far. It's been great up to this point, and what a game tonight. Again, our final, the Bears 59, Colonia 55. So for Phil Hill and Jim Allender, I'm John Migliaro saying thanks for being with us.